Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning to you all, student.
Yes.
As we have started the chapter, Glimpses of the Past, chapter number 3 from our main test book, Honeydew, and was written by S.D. Savant in a historical way. And he was making us remember about so many glimpses, we can say, that short view of the people who had struggled for Indian freedom. And so many topics we have seen from the first video, that the martyrs, who the leaders of India who has been struggling for Indian freedom. And the next we have seen the company's conquest, the East India Company who captured our territory. And the next we have seen about the British rule, how they are ruling our country, and the religious people also of India, how they are making the people to follow so many practices which was absurd. And also we have seen about Rajaram Mohan Roy, who was a strong believer in education and knowledge to make them people. And we can say that he is also a modern, and scientifically he used to think about the situation and everything, who wanted it in a practical way. He was also trying his level best to make the people understand about the situation and how they are blindly following the British through so many things. And the first step he was taken is the newspaper, which was also stopped by the British. Like so many things we have seen in the last two lectures of this chapter. And today we are going to see, yes, the next topic we are going to see is the oppression, which was fought between 1765 till 1835. Yes, in this 1818, a resolution was passed. A rule was passed. Under it, an Indian could be jailed without trial in a court. Yes, that is, in that the Indian could be put into the jail without having trial in a court, without having justice in a court, without discussing that matter in a court, they are put in the jail. Yes, the British officers drew large salaries. They are getting large salaries by making them slave in India. By making the work done by the people of India, they are getting huge salaries because of that. Yes, besides, they made fortunes in business. By 1829, Britain was exporting goods worth 7 crore rupees to India. Even the British Governor General of India, Bentinck, reported to England that the bones of cotton weavers are bleaching the plains of India. Thus, the British prospered on the ruins of Indian industry. Here, the British are saying that by 1829, they are getting huge amount from the Britain, as they are exporting goods worth how many rupees worth? It was 7 crore rupees to India. And even the British Governor General of India, in 1818, the British Governor General of India was Bentinck, William Bentinck, and he was telling to England, to his hometown, that the bones of cotton weavers are bleaching the plains of India. That means their life has been ruining. They are working for us in such a way that they are dying of starvation. Because the cotton which was available in India is not available in any of the country, and the demand of that cloth is also more. So what they are doing? They are making the people of India to work day and night, and they are making the wealth from that. And they are importing, exporting, whatever they are doing, they are having a huge profits from that. And the Governor General is informing to England about the situation of India, that the bones of the people, viewers, are bleaching in the plains of India, and through that ruining of Indian industry, they are prospering on the outside by making profits. Yes, through the textual way you but the British continue to oppress. That is, not they are against the Indians, that In 1818, they passed a regulation, that is a rule, that under which an Indian could be jailed. An Indian could be jailed that without first being tried in a court. That means the discussion is not going on in the court only about whether they have done that right or wrong. Just that discussion is not going, thus they are put into the jail without asking for their justification. Yes, what they are doing next? At the same time, the British officers in India got big salaries and also made fortunes in private business. They are making private business by making the people of India as slaves. As they are having all the goods which they want, they are making the Indians to do that, and they are taking from them, and they are having a very good salary through that. And the Indian industry began dying. That means the Indian industries, the people are dying because of starvation. And on the other side, the British prospered on the company's loot. As the people are not there in the industries of the Indian, they are, the Britishers are looting the companies of India. And through this, by 1829, for example, Britain was exporting goods worth 7 crore rupees to India each year. Each year, the Britishers are getting 7 crore rupees through the goods which they are sending to Britain. And they are getting the goods of 7 crore rupees through that. And the Governor General is telling to the hometown, that is England, that the bales of cotton weavers are ruining the plains of, we can say, the bleaching the plains of India. We can see that under British rule, India was forced to supply tons of raw materials, raw cotton, to factories in England and import mill cloth. With the influx of inexpensive and easy to maintain mill cloth, weavers lost their livelihood, and when famine or natural calamity struck, they died tragically without the means to sustain themselves. Remarking on these happenings in the mid-19th century, Lord Bentinck regretted that the bones of cotton weavers are bleaching the plains of India. So this was the statement given by Governor General William Bentinck to his hometown England. So see the condition of Indian people, how they are dying of starvation and famine because of the work given by the Britishers, and how they are enjoying through that. Yes, you can see here in this sixth topic, that is dissatisfaction, which was also fought between 1835 till 56. In 1835, Lord Macaulay, one of the Englishmen, suggested that the medium of language in India should be English. The proposal was carried. So what the other thing the English people want to do? That they wanted to change the medium of education of India also. And what they are doing? They are changing the language, that is to be in English. And the proposal which they have been put was also accepted. Yes, the main aim was to produce, was to make an army of clerks. Clerks, the low-level work of the people to assist the British, to be like make the to be the assistant of the British, like to take something or to do something like that, small work which can be done by the Indian people, staying on their own country and making the people slave as a clerk is very, we can say that very bad condition of India. But what they are doing? But the other side, the British is thinking that if we will propose something new, they think that we are making them, educating them. but they will not understand, as the British think that the Indians will not understand the hidden meaning of that, why they are trying to educate the people of India. Yes, it happened, but it also produced a new generation of intellectuals. Yes, it happened. What happened? The people also accepted, and people started to learn the language, and they have produced a new generation of intellectuals. By learning a new language, people will be thinking that they have been in a new generation of becoming intelligent. Some of them tried to educate the masses. Some of the people started to educate the people in a big, huge mass. Some decided to convey the grievances of the people to the British Parliament, and some decided to convey the grievances, sadness of the people, to the British Parliament about their sadness, we can say misery, to the British Parliament about that, because they are losing their own language. They are not learning their own language, and they are learning the language of some other country. So some of them are conveying about that to the British Parliament. Through the textual, we can see education in India was in Persian and Sanskrit. In 1835, an Englishman named Macaulay suggested a change. So first in India, English, we can say that English was not a language. Education was done in the language of Persian and Sanskrit. And in 1835, the Englishman named Macaulay was suggested a change. He was suggesting a change in the language. What he is suggesting? We should teach the natives through the English language. He is suggesting the native people of India to learn the English language. And I concurred, because with a concern he was saying like that, he was making the people to believe on him. And we think the language, and we have to change the people's language, to change their mindset. As the people's mindset is that Britishers means they are making us slave, and they are making us push in doing some work that are not carried out to be a good way. And they are putting heavy taxes, like they are enmity, like that the Indian people are thinking. To change the mindset, we have to change the language of the people, so that they will also understand something about us. Like that they started to think. But see that English education produced clerks to whom the British gave petty jobs. The English education has been proposed to the people of India, and they also made so many clerks of India to do some petty works. That is, petty means a small works under them. Incidentally, it also produced a new generation of intellectuals. That means people are becoming intellectual by learning a new language of English. So here, people started to talk about this matter in their area, like, we must educate our brothers. Some people started to say that we must educate our brothers also, the king started to say, and try to improve their material condition. By educating through the language, we can materially, what, the condition of the people, we can change. And for that, we must convey our grievances to the British Parliament. So what, as the English language is given to them, they thought that the British will also think about whatever their problems also. They wanted to tell their sadness about the situation, because the taxes were so heavy that they are not able to pay, like doing their own work. They have to work even more to pay for that. So they wanted to convey the grievances. They wanted to convey their misery to the British Parliament. Now you can see in the map also, by 1856, the British had conquered all of India. Yes, in the first video you have seen, small portion of the part of India was only captured by India. We are captured by British. But here you can see the India has been captured totally by the British. Maximum was captured by the British people. Yes, how they are making the people fools, we can say. But they cared a little about the needs of India. At the same time, they are caring about the Indian people somewhat, little bit, and lands. They are also caring about the Indian people and about their lands also. So they are converting our brothers. Some people are saying that they are converting our people to their language. And what is the use of that? Some people are talking about that. You are only talk. Do something to drive them out. Like some people are saying that they are converting our Indian people. And some other are saying that you are just only talking about that. You are not just driving them out from that. That means you are not opposing them. You are just only talking about that matter. Like that some people started to say. And some others say, our kings have become puppets. And we have lost our jobs and families. Puppets, which means following whatever they are saying. Like that. Whatever they say, they will say yes to that. Like that, they become puppets, follower. Blindly following somebody like that. Our kings, that means the kings of India, are became the puppets of the British people. And we have lost our jobs and families. We have lost our jobs and families because the industries have boomed, because the people are not able to work. They are dying of starvation. So jobs, families, all this lose of that. So what we can do here? We are now blindly want to support them. And what we can do for them? We cannot do anything like that. Some people said, our kings have been in the hands of British. And now what we can do, whatever they say, we have to just blindly follow it and we have to go behind them like that some other say. So this was the condition of the people when the language is also changed, they are not able to oppose them. So I hope you have understood the story till here. Understood the past happenings till here, and we will do the next topic in the next part of the video. Thank you and have a nice day.